Yes, sir.
Yeah.
अबे भोसड़ी के रिकॉर्डिंग हो रही है.
Regarding your unit 2, this unit 2, we are going to study about boilers. And for last class, we didn't have our lecture. That class has been rescheduled to next Saturday. Next Saturday, we have planned for a lecture. Because the industry people, they can come only during Saturdays. Okay. We are inviting a person, Chief Manager of Cabinet Operations from Navy Union Corporation. Power plant in Tamil Nadu. It is one of the biggest power plants. It is one of the biggest power plants in Tamil Nadu. Okay. We are inviting a person from Navy Union Corporation. He is Chief Manager for Cabinet Operations. Okay. So, we have 1 hour lecture alone. Okay. You tell me the time, whether it can be 9 to 10 or 10 to 11. Only 1 hour. That day's attendance will be considered for your previous class attendance. It is clear. 7th February, we have best lecture in the same class. Is it clear? Okay. Let's come to our unit 2. So, this unit 2, we are going to study about. Don't touch it. We are going to study about boilers. So, in this lecture session, we are going to discuss about definitions of boiler, various classification of boilers, and boiler mechanics.
Sir,
see, in the second lecture, I remember, while discussing about thermal power plant, I have told you about boiler accessories and boiler mountings. Boiler mountings are devices which are placed in boiler in order to protect the boiler or the reference to the safety of the boiler and the personnel who is operating the boiler. The devices that are placed in the boiler for the safety of the boiler and the safety of the personnel who is operating the boiler, those devices we use to call as boiler mountings. Correct? And you have boiler accessories. These devices are used to enhance the performance of the boiler. Boiler accessories are the devices which are used to improve the efficiency of the boiler. You have two things, one is boiler mounting and another is boiler accessories. So in this session, we will be discussing about boiler mountings. Okay? So we are going to discuss about various definitions of boiler, classification of boiler and boiler mountings. Coming to the overview. This is the overview. And the definition of a boiler, it can be defined like this. For boiler is something called a heat exchanger, where you have phase change process. Okay. What is the purpose of a boiler? You are going to produce steam. So what you have to supply? What is the input? Water. You have to supply water, which will undergo phase change process, and you will get water in the vapor form, which we call as steam. To have this phase change process to occur, you have to supply heat. Right? And that will be supplied in the form of fuel. You can have coal-fired boiler, you can have oil-fired boiler, you can have gas-fired boiler. Depending on the type of boiler, we will supply the fuel also. Okay? Along with the fuel, that day like in the second lecture, I have told you to fire triangle or combustion triangle. For combustion to occur, we need to have three components, like three sides of a triangle. One we call it as the fuel, other one we call it as oxygen or air, then you need to have heat. Similarly, in the case of the combustion chamber of the boiler also, we have to supply fuel, air and heat to start the combustion. Okay. So, your boiler is nothing but a heat exchanger where you are going to have change of phase for the water input state to the vapor state. And you can define like this also. This is a closed vessel in which water is converted to steam above atmospheric pressure with application of heat. Okay. So, in general, your boilers are nothing but steam generators. Coming to the classification, the primary element of a boiler. So here the experiment of a boiler, you need to have a safe environment to produce steam. So the container should be safe and the steam should be delivered at the required pressure or the operating pressure of the plant. Right? If you are going to have a process where we need to have, let's say, pressure of steam and fiber. So your boiler should be able to produce steam and fiber pressure. And the maximum heat produced in the furnace should be utilized with the economy. Means with this amount of money being spent, you will produce steam. So these are the various requirements of boiler. Applications for power generations, we use boilers, and even for locomotive of ships, right? We have steam turbines driving the ship. So those steam turbines are driven by the working medium is going to steam. So you need to have a boiler. And in various industries like your textile mill or BG coffee cloth, in the pulp and paper industry, in fertilizer plant, right? In the confectionery plant, in many places, you find boilers are being used, or steam are being used. So, coming to the classification of boiler, basically classify, the fundamental classification of boiler is like your 5-tube boiler and 1-tube boiler. Right? In the case of your boiler, you will have tubes and shell. Right? It's a heat exchanger, where you will have many tubes and a shell. Here you can have the flue gas to pass through the tube, and the tubes are being surrounded by water. This one combination. Or you can allow the water to pass through the tubes, and the tubes are being surrounded by the flue gas. Okay? These two possibilities are there. If the flue gas are going to pass through the tubes, and the tubes are going to be surrounded by water, that boiler we call it as 5-tube boiler. The flue gas is inside the tube, surrounded by water. Or instead, if you are going to have water inside the tube, surrounded by the flue gas, or products of combustion from the furnace of the boiler, then those boilers we use to call it as 1-tube boiler. Okay, this is a fundamental classification. This we do like this. Let us say I want less amount of steam, or mass product of the steam, or quantity of steam required is less, but the pressure required is more. There are two possibilities. Then we go for 1-tube boiler. 1-tube boilers produces steam with high pressure, but the amount of steam that is coming out of the boiler will be less. Mass flow rate or volume flow rate or quantity of steam coming from the boiler will be less, but the pressure of the steam will be higher. That is in the case of your 1-tube boilers. Let us say I want more quantity of steam, not pressure. I want more amount of steam, and pressure can be 2 bar or 2.5 bar or 3 bar pressure. So pressure is less, then we go for 5-tube boiler. In the case of 5-tube boiler, the amount of steam produced is more because your water is going to be present inside the shell. Within the tube, you are going to have two gases. Right? So, more amount of water is present because your shell is going to obey everything. So, in the shell, you are going to have water. Through the tube, you are going to have two gases. So, you can produce more amount of steam, but the pressure of the steam will be less comparatively. And there are other possibilities of classifying boilers. Like you can have a horizontal boiler, axis of boiler can be horizontal, or you can have vertical boiler, axis in the vertical direction. So that is also one more classification. And depending upon the location of furnace, you can have internally fired boiler or externally fired boiler. Predominantly these days we have only internally fired boilers. If we don't provide a couple of example, a separate area. Earlier we were having. So now we have like internally fired boiler. When we had trains being run by steam engine, we used to have a separate combustion chamber, and then that flue gas will go to the boiler compartment to the steam. So these days we don't have external fired boiler. We have mostly internally fired boiler. And we have boilers like stationary and mobile. Mobile means if you want to use a boiler for running a ship, for driving a steam turbine, which is used to propel a ship, then it is moving, which is a mobile boiler. Or in the industries, where it is a textile mill, or pulp and paper industry, or a sugar plant. So there we'll be having the area where your boilers will be fixed. Okay, those boilers are also used to propel this. And depending on the pressure that we develop, so these boilers are also can be classified like high pressure boilers, medium pressure boilers, and these are the various classifications of boilers. And in India, we have Indian Boiler Regulation Act 1950 is there. So depending upon that, our government of India, they have nominated an authority who will be issuing the certificate to operate the boiler. That starts right from the manufacturing of the boiler. So they have certain codes. So when you want to manufacture a boiler, you have to follow the codes. Indian pilot replaces. And if the operating pressure is less than 3.5 bar, then it is not necessary to go for the certification for the IBR. So let us say if you are going to have an industry and you are going to have a boiler to run the industry, then within the state government, you will be having a person called boiler inspector. Under the Ministry of Industries, you will be having a person named boiler inspector. So he will come and inspect. Regularly they will be coming and inspecting the boiler. Right? They will, and you need to have a logbook where you will be noting on the parameters, operating parameters, and how frequently you will be cleaning the boilers, all those things will be log, and that will be inspected by the boiler inspector. He is a government authority to come and inspect. So based on this, we have to look at the boiler. IBR boiler, this comes under the air boiler regulation. And there are boilers that are going to operate at low pressure, like pressure less than 3.5 bar pressure. Those boilers we call as non-IBR boilers, which does not occur the inspection by the boiler inspector. And apart from this, we have package boilers. Like normally, if it is like a thermal power plant, where to generate power, if you are going to commission a boiler, there they will not come as a ready-made product. There they will be constructing the boiler. In the site they will be doing the construction. It is like a 4-5 story building. A huge boiler will be there for the power plant. That they will be constructing, erecting, commissioning on the site. Apart from that, for the industry, if you want to use the boiler and the if it is going to be a low pressure boiler and if you are going to operate with less amount of steam, then we have a type of boiler called package boiler. These boilers will be manufactured at some particular place in an industry, and from there it will be transported to the location where you want to place. So it will come as a ready-made product. You can have it. You have to specify the pressure, operating pressure, quantity of steam that you will get. You used to say like in terms of 2 tons per hour, 3 tons per hour, that will tell you the mass unit of the steam. And the operating pressure, let's say 5 bar pressure, you specify. So the specification of the boiler will be specifying, and it will be manufactured in a place. And from there you can transport it and you can replace the oil for your applications. So those boilers we call it as package boilers. The advantages of package boilers are given here. Coming to the boiler mountings. As I said earlier, boiler mountings are few devices which will be incorporated or placed or fitted within the boiler with reference to the safety of the boiler as well as safety of the person who is operating the boiler. Safety of the personnel and safety of the boiler, for which we have these 10 devices which we call as boiler mounts. It is like gauge glass. Gauge glass is nothing but water level indicator which indicates the level of water within the boiler. It is the responsibility of the boiler operator to make sure sufficient quantity of water is present inside the boiler. Right? So for that, to indicate the water level, we have gauge glass. When we get into the gauge glass, this diagram shows like various components, all those components. Initially for boiler mounting I have listed 10 components, right? 10 devices I have listed. In that 2 it is not indicated here. Those are one is fusible plug and one is gauge glass. Apart from all other valves which is necessary as boiler mounting that has been listed here. Okay. You have feed check valve, this is feed check valve. Location I have given in this schematic diagram, where those valves will be based in the boiler that is given here. So your feed check valve will be here at the high regulation. And you will be having pressure relief valve. And maybe the purpose of pressure relief valve. This is pressure gauge, which indicates the pressure that is inside the boiler. And this is your safety valve. And this is mainstream stop valve, this is purge valve, this is stump valve, this is blow down valve. So you have different types of valves in order to operate the boiler safely. This is schematic diagram, and this is a feed pump with which we will be supplying water to the boiler to produce steam. So, coming to gauge glass, your gauge glass will be like this. Let us say this is the shell of the boiler. Right? You assume that you are going to have a cylindrical shell which contains water in it. Okay? With that we are going to produce, that we are going to make it as a steam. So what will happen is that part of the space in your steam drum, you will be having water. Above the water, you will be having steam. So we call it a steam phase and water phase. So to certain level you will be having water. Above the water you will be having steam. Is it clear? So your air glass will be fixed like this. So it has two tubes like this. Then you will have a air glass. So this will indicate the level of water. So this phase is your steam phase. This is water phase. Okay. So normally when a boiler operator operates the boiler, he will be having like he will check whether the water level comes to 1/4 of the gauge glass. Right? Approximately. When the water level comes to 1/4 of the gauge glass, he will start the boiler feed pump. When he starts the boiler feed pump, what will happen? Water is being pumped in. Level of water increases. When it comes to 3/4 of the gauge glass, he will switch off the pump. Boiler pump will be your boiler feed pump will switch on when the water level comes to 1/4 in the gauge glass, and when the water level starts to rise, when it comes to 3/4 of the gauge glass, it will stop. Is it clear? And after a certain time period of operation, what will happen is like your gauge glass will not indicate the level of water properly. Right? There may be some amount of air present or moisture present above this, and your gauge glass will not be visible properly. You cannot see the presence of water inside the gauge glass. So in such cases, what we will be doing, we will be blowing through the gauge glass. So the boiler operator does a process called blowing through of gauge glass. That means he will clear the whatever that is present inside this gauge glass so that it will be more visible. You can see the level of water inside this. For which what we will be doing, you have three cocks here. These are small valves, which we call as cock. There are three cocks present here, C1, C2 and C3. So now what he will do, normally this car, this is a drain car, this will be in shut position. Okay? This is in shut position. The convention that is followed is, when the valve is parallel to the pipeline, we call it as open. When the valve is perpendicular to the pipeline, we call it as shut. So now in this diagram, this is shut. This is a pipeline, this is the valve, handle of the valve is like this. So this is in shut position. Okay? So now in normal operation what will happen, these two valves will be open. These two cocks will be opened and this is in shut position. So you are going to see the level of water. Now I am going to blow through the gauge glass. To blow through the gauge glass, what we have to do? So these two cocks I have to close. Already this is in shut position. Shut these two valves. Both valves are shut. Now you open the drain valve. Is it clear? You have three valves. This is already in shut position and these two are in open position. So now what you do? You shut this valve and this valve. Then open the drain valve. Whatever water that is present inside the gauge glass, it will get drained. Is it clear? Then you shut the valve. Okay? Then you open this valve and this valve. Open these two valves. Okay? Before opening, you have drained the valve. You have drained the water that is present in the gauge glass. Now you have to blow through. For that, you open this valve alone. This is in shut position, this is in shut position. You open this valve alone. So high pressure steam will pass through this and it will clear whatever that is present inside the gauge glass. High pressure steam will flow through and it will clear everything that is present in this. Then you shut this valve. Okay? You shut this valve, drain valve also is shut. Open this valve, open this valve. Now your gauge glass will have more visibility. You can see the water, the level of water that is present inside the gauge glass. So this normally the boiler operator he will be doing whenever he goes for a round. So blowing through of gauge glass is done periodically. Okay. So this is very important component in the boiler, because if there is no the amount of water present in the your boiler is less, normally what will happen is that you will have a control room from where you will be controlling all the parameters. Okay. So engineers will be sitting, we used to call it as operating engineer or engineer operations. He will be there in the control room, he will be controlling. So when the water level comes down, you will get the alarm. Low level alarm will come. Right? So this operating of the boiler feed pump, it can be done under manual mode as well as in automatic mode. In the control room, you will be having a knob which you can operate. So you can put it in manual mode or in auto mode as well as in manual mode. Let us say if it is in manual mode. Right? If it is in auto mode, then alarm will come and automatically the boiler feed pump will start. If it is in manual mode, let us say some problem is there, you made it in manual mode, and if the alarm is not coming. So it is the responsibility of the boiler attender or boiler operator to make sure the water level in the boiler. If the boiler level goes too below, then your shell and tubes will get overheated and you will have twisting of the boiler or buckling of the boiler will occur. The boiler will fail. So in order to avoid that, this normally we will be having alarm. When the water level goes less, then alarm will come, then we will start the boiler feed pump. Then what will happen? Water will be pumped in. Similarly, when the water level comes to a certain level, when it reaches high level, then high level alarm will be. Okay? Then we will start the boiler feed. These are we will be operating. So the main purpose of your gas glass is to indicate the water level in the boiler. So this is how your gas glass will appear. Okay, you have two different types and it will be located like this. Your gas glass is located like this. Coming to the next boiler mounting, pressure gauges. So pressure gauges will be placed on top of the boiler. Right, on top of the boiler we will be having a pressure gauge. It is also called a steam gauge. It indicates the pressure of the steam present inside the boiler. So normally, like let us say you want to have a boiler of operating pressure 5 bar or let us say 10 bar operating pressure, then the boiler will be designed to which pressure? What is missing pressure? 1.5 times your operating pressure. Let us say your working pressure or operating pressure is 10 bar, then we design the boiler for 15 bar pressure. Yes, it means your design pressure or design parameter will be 1.5 times the working parameter. So it will get 15 bar pressure. Okay. So whenever we go wrong, we will be making sure, let us say you cannot exactly maintain 10 bar pressure. The operating pressure is 10 bar. So we will be operating between 8 to 12 bar. When the boiler pressure comes to 12 bar, that means it is in serious condition, means you are crossing the limit. So in such cases, we will be releasing the steam to reduce the pressure. So that the device which is used to release the pressure of the boiler, that manually, that we call as a relief valve. Normally for your pressure gauges, we used to have a device called Godan gauge. This is called Godan gauge. So here you are, this part will be connected to the boiler. So because of the expansion, you will be having a lever here, which will expand the pressure, and it indicates, this dial will indicate the pressure inside the boiler. This is pressure relief valve. Okay. This pressure relief valve, we have two actually. Yeah. These are the pressure relief valve. I have told you, like, let us say you have a boiler which is operating at 10 bar pressure. Means we cannot exactly maintain 10 bar pressure, we will be operating between 8 bar to 12 bar. Right? So now let us say the pressure has come to 12 bar. Right? It has come to 12 bar. The boiler is designed for 15 bar. So you will have safety valve and relief valve. This relief valve will be operated manually. Safety valve will operate automatically. It is spring loaded. Okay? Let us say if you are going to operate the boiler at 10 bar pressure and design pressure is 15 bar, then your safety valve will be set at 13 bar. You are going to operate between 8 to 12 bar. Is it clear? Operating pressure is 10 bar and within the range of 8 to 12 bar you are going to operate. 15 bar is the design pressure. At 13 bar or 14 bar, your safety valve will be set. And when the boiler operator goes to the boiler and he found that the pressure has come to 12 bar or 12.5 bar, he wants to reduce the pressure. So what he will do? He will operate this pressure relief valve. You will have a pressure relief valve like this. Here, a chain will be hanging. You put this chain, you can open this valve. So from 12.5 bar, so the steam that is present there, that will go to the atmosphere. So your pressure will come down. When it comes to 8 bar, you will leave. So this is done manually in order to protect the boiler. That is done by the boiler operator manually. Okay. So this will be operated by operating this lever. At this end of the lever, you will have a chain. You can operate. Or like this also, you will be having a lever. You can open. So it will release the steam. When the required pressure comes, then automatically you can close it. Okay? So that is the purpose of your pressure relief valve. Pressure relief valve is operated manually by the boiler operator if the operating the pressure of the boiler is more than the operating pressure. Then we have safety valve. This safety valve operates automatically. It is a spring-loaded valve. So we can adjust the pressure or operating pressure of this valve. Let us say I am setting this relief valve pressure as 13 bar and the boiler is unattended. Boiler operator has gone somewhere or he is visiting some notice, if the boiler is unnoticed, unattended, and the pressure has gone to 13 bar, nobody is there, then what will happen? This pressure will release. It will release the pressure. When this starts opening, what will happen? You will have a pipeline which carries the steam. Okay, that is being led to the atmosphere. There in the pipeline we used to have a cooter. Right? Yeah, alarm will be there. Right? When this valve operates, then alarm will come automatically. It sounds louder. Wherever the boiler operator is there, he will come. Our engineer who is there in the plant, they will come to the boiler. That means it has crossed the limit. Right? It has gone more than 13 bar pressure, for example. So this will operate automatically. So now we will be having two safety valves. Because even if one fails, other one will operate. Okay, so this will operate automatically. So these boiler mountings are for the safety of the boiler as well as for the safety of the personnel who is operating. This is feed check valve. We are pumping water with the help of feed pump to the boiler. Yes, right. To the inlet of the boiler, we have feed check valve. If you see the schematic, basic schematic diagram of the boiler, you can see feed check valve. Okay. And these feed check valves, you will have two in number in series, not in parallel. You will have two feed check valves in series. When I say check valve, it means it is non-return valve. Means it will allow the flow of the fluid only in a particular direction, not in the other direction. Opposite direction flow will not occur. These are all non-return valves. Flow will occur only in this direction. Because what will happen, let us say, you are pumping water to the boiler, correct? This is allowing the fluid to enter into the boiler in this direction. Here you have an pressurized chamber. This container is pressurized. This is a pressure vessel. Boiler is a pressure vessel. You have higher pressure here. Because of higher pressure, assume that you have an ordinary valve here. Steam will come through this. When you stop this pump, when the boiler feed pump is not operating, you will be having presence of steam here in this line. If the pipeline breaks, then it is hazardous. Normally, we will be having a feed check valve, which is a non-return valve, which will allow the water to enter into the boiler. And backflow of any medium through this is stopped. To make sure we have double, two in number. Even if this fails, this will protect. So, you will be having two feed check valves in line, okay? Not in parallel. In series, you will be having two feed check valves. So, this is the purpose of your feed check valve, which will allow the water to enter into the boiler and it will not allow the steam to backflow. This is our feed check valve. Then we have main steam stop valve. Slide for the schematic diagram. This is the outlet of the boiler, steam outlet from the boiler. Through this pipeline only water leaves for various applications, for various process we are going to send steam through this pipeline only. To regulate the flow you have main steam stopper. This is the main valve from the boiler you can control. Depending upon the quantity of steam that you require, you can open and close. So the complete regulating of the steam is done from the main steam stopper. This can also be motorized. And you can control remotely. By sitting in the control room also you can operate. Different positions of opening can be done. Remote operated. Or locally also you can operate. You can go to the boiler, at the top of the boiler, you can manually also open. You can operate this valve both locally as well as from the remote. So that is the purpose of main steam stop valve. Just like this. Then you have a blowdown valve. Blowdown valve is like, this is the schematic diagram of the boiler plant. This valve is blowdown valve. When you operate the boiler for a longer time period, right? So what will happen is that whatever sediments that is present in water, that will settle at the bottom of the valve. Correct? That will try to settle. Even though we have a separate demineralized plant or DM plant,